Hello and welcome to the stream. I'm back. And I'm in a different place. Physically. Like in real life. Not just like emotionally or something. I have moved to a new apartment. And there's a lot of junk in my room still. But I am here to stream.
You're not meant to be in here.
Yo, thank you for the subscription, the resub, I should say. 8 months, man. How you doing, Yipa-chan? Let me transition real quick. Hi. How is everybody doing? I'm so glad to be back. It's a good feeling, you know? Working hard still? You mean me? No, I'm sure you mean yourself. Because I ain't been doing nothing. No, I have been moving, but even so, I could be doing more. Oh, man. Yeah, I don't envy your job, man. Grinding back to top 500 in Overwatch with a player called Nilo's Kitten. Bruh. Someone naming their username, their account after you. Or I guess your account. Specifically in that context of being your kitten. Oh, man. Couldn't be me. Also, I technically just got a promotion at work. Oh, nice. Well, congrats, man. Oh, no. Hold on. I just realized the lens on my webcam is, like, super dirty. Bear with me. I'm going to try to clean it. And the tracking is going to go a little wonky for a second. I have no idea what it's doing on screen. I don't have it viewable. There you go. Hopefully that's better. I have no idea if I just froze or something for a second there. It got dirty because I was trying to clean it earlier. It's a good idea when you move. If you haven't moved before, you haven't moved in a long time, or you don't move often. It's a good idea when you move to clean things, you know? It's just good practice, right? You move them when you remove them from your old place, and then you move, you clean them when you move them from your old place, and then you clean other stuff when you put them in the new place, right? And so I was cleaning everything around my desk, right? Like, the carpet's fine. So I went and wiped down the whole desk, you know, just got all the dust off of it. Same thing with my mouse pad. I gave it a good little clean. You could actually use a little bit more. It's still a little gamer gunky, you know. My mouse could use a little bit more, but it's hard to clean it with the buttons it has. The configuration's a little weird. Anyway, and I just remember I was cleaning the webcam. Because, you know, it had some dust on it, and I went and wiped the lens off and then saw that it was kind of leaving some moisture because I was just using, like, a damp cloth. And then I totally forgot about that. I remember thinking, oh, I need to get, like, some alcohol wipes and give this a better clean. And I just forgot. And went and did other stuff. And so I just looked at the lens of it, and I'm like, oh, geez, all those little water spots dried up and, you know, covered up the lens, so... I'm surprised the tracking was working as well as it, you know, as it was.
It was me all along, strong boy.
Anyway, getting into the game. Next week in Destiny, Grandmasters begin. That's nice. So starting tomorrow, Supremacy and Momentum come back. Lightblade is going to be the first GM, and I believe even though the GMs are starting early, It's only going to be whatever the weekly is until later in the season. Then it'll unlock all of them at some point. I'm not sure when that is. But I'm okay with this. I don't really mind. Because otherwise, like, what always ends up happening is you just end up doing whatever the easiest GM is. And then you get, like, all these people on LFG, you know, like, everybody's doing a different Nightfall. And it's hard to find someone doing the particular Nightfall you're trying to do. Unless it's, like, a notoriously easy one or something. And even then, that's not usually an easy farm to find. It's a mess. So I think doing it like this is more consistent. I think I do prefer that. Let's see. Rotators, Gambit, Ranks. Okay, I might actually do some Gambit this upcoming week. Vault of Glass Raid. Cool. Yelena will be happy to carry people. And Shattered Throne, which is pretty lame, not gonna lie. So I can't stick around for too long. I just can't, you know. I got work in the morning. I was doing stuff today. I was unpacking, you know, sitting on my desk. And then I was So I went to work, I got back, and I was supposed to get started on unpacking a bunch of stuff, because so far it's mostly just been packing that we've been doing, like, all weekend, basically. We were packing earlier this week, and then this weekend we were moving everything. And so now everything, except for, like, a few items here and there, is in the new apartment, the new place. Yo, what's up, Wavy? Oh, I got a projection. I didn't even know that. I'm just going to double check that there's nothing in the store I need to grab before the reset happens, namely Bright Dust stuff. I think we're okay there. Do I want the crimson ornament? I don't think I do. It's cool, but I genuinely don't think I'll use it over the one I currently use. I don't know why it's showing the default ornament. I have the spiky one. That's the one I like, the spiky one. Wait, it's showing... Hold on, it's showing the default ornament for the preview, which it's not supposed to do. And it's also showing the catalyst... You see that little, like, loading bar at the bottom of the icon? It's showing the catalyst as if I haven't completed it, which I definitely have. So, I don't know what's going on there. I think that happened with some other exotic the other day. Anyway. Hi, Wavy. So, I'm a little excited. I got this new apartment. I've been moving in past few days. Finally, like, everything's here that needs to be here. There are, again, just, like, a few odds and ends, and then we got to go back and clean the apartment. But we literally have the entire rest of the month to clean the apartment, get it inspected, and get our deposit back and all that stuff. And we're not even halfway through the month yet. And so we still have a good chunk of time. That doesn't mean we're going to slack off and not do it. But it means that the hardest part, which is honestly just all the moving, the packing, the moving, and the unpacking, the hardest part is gone. That's over. Except for the unpacking, which is the hardest part of the hardest part. In my opinion, every single time I've moved, unpacking has always been the hardest part. I don't know why. I struggle with it. I struggle. I can't think of any time I've truly moved into a home and not had any cardboard boxes of stuff from my last move. And this gets compounded to the point where, I think I probably, in a lot of instances, have had boxes from, like, 2 moves ago, 3 moves ago, that I just never really had the need to open back up. Or I didn't really put in a good storage spot, or whatever, right? And I wanna break that habit as best I can. I really wanna fully move in to this apartment. It's just, I don't know, it's tough, man. It's real, real, It's real tough if you're like not used to it, right? Because I've moved before, and the moving's not a problem. Again, the only thing that gets me is the damn unpacking, man. And it's tough. It's even more tough because, like, I've mentioned it before, but like I think I could live out of a shoebox if it was big enough for just my desk and PC and my bed, right? Like, if I could just, you know, stream and then sleep and then I guess use a bathroom somewhere, if there was only space for those three things and nothing else, I could live pretty comfortably. Now, the ceiling would have to be tall enough for me to not bonk my head. Immersion break. I'm not in reality a 6-inch tall gnome. I am in fact a 6-foot tall being. You know, I'm just trying to not hit my head on things. That's all. To nobody. There's no second chance. I already bought it. No third degree. Checking. Turning back to nobody. There's no second chance. No third degree. But yeah, just trying to get things figured out. Yeah, so I was unpacking today, and my only two goals were fully set up my desk and fully set up my my clothes section, right? Like where I'm going to put all my clothes. Because I got a lot of clothes, you know? And, you know, I'm just trying to figure out the best way to store them. Because I've got a closet, but I've never been good about, like, folding my clothes and putting them in a closet. And I almost feel like if I don't have a closet and I just kind of have open storage, like, in my room, there's, like, less of a barrier physically, but then also less of a barrier mentally. So I don't think of it as another step to put my clothes away. I just think of, oh, let me just like do my laundry and then, you know, here, let me take them out of the like laundry machine, right? Laundry machine. Let me take it out of the dryer and then, and just immediately put them away instead of like, oh, let me, you know, take them out of the dryer and then fold them and then walk over to my closet and open the door and cram them in as best as I can. Like, I don't know. For some reason, it's just like a visual barrier, if anything. Of just, I don't know. I feel like it makes sense in my head. And it could be one of those things where I'm like, this is going to change my life. Surely, like, it's going to improve everything for me. And then, like, I do it, and it makes no difference at all. So let's test it out, the open chat, I guess. But, ooh, I guess I should do Last Wish. How hard do you think it is to find a group for Last Wish? At the last minute. So I guess that's what we'll do tonight. We'll do Last Wish, and then I'll probably call it. But yeah, so I was unpacking stuff and trying to get my desk set up and cleaning everything off and doing a great job. But I only really got started because my sister came over. And, you know, she's the reason why we moved apartments in the first place. is because she was moving in with us.
Can be loved. You are the only one. Read your smile. This is the aftermath. Whatever I've done.
But yeah, that's hold on. I'm gonna join a group real quick. Yo,
hello there. Dude, Connor.
Yeah.
Everyone's at Charlotte's and shit looks so lame. It's so funny.
Dude, always lame.
I don't know why they do that. I'd rather stay on a lot of Destiny.
We got a join code somewhere?
Lizard's got it in the bio.
Google. I've done Last Wish before. I'm going to deafen for like a minute or two, but I'm going to join good. Up. Should be okay. I just gotta talk to somebody.
Yeah. Yeah. Astro, you done this before?
You guys are the somebody. Feel special. How about that? But you know, I was just unpacking and because my sister was there and I was like, I guess it's time to actually get stuff done because I was just tired from work. Because I was tired from moving all weekend, and then I had to go to work in the morning, and I was up late last night, because I had to do a bunch of stuff, and I had to, like, take care of all that, like, late at night, and it was really annoying how late it ended up being, and so I was up till like 3 in the morning, and I had to work at like 9:45, and I'm like, damn, dude, like, this sucks. Or maybe I was up till 2 in the morning, because I remember I got 6 hours of sleep, or almost did. It was just, you know, it was a little frustrating, to say the least.
Love is a joke, but fate is hilarious. It does what it wants. Burns in your tail through the swamp.
But let me try to wrap up the story. So my sister got here, but she was with her boyfriend and their mutual friend. I'd never met that other guy before, but they were here, and they were getting some of her stuff moved, some of her stuff set up, like her backpack, not backpack, what am I saying, her bed and stuff like that, and then they were like, oh, let's go get something to eat, and I was like, all right, I guess so, and my brother didn't, even though he had driven them here, he didn't want to drive them back. And so he's like, oh, you know, you drive them back. And I was fine with it. You know, I hadn't seen my sister in a bit. So I was fine with it. Long story short, I guess it just ended up taking a lot longer than we were expecting. Or at least than I was expecting. And yeah, it was just a little bit longer than I was expecting. I'm trying to think of what all needs to be mentioned. Oh yeah, okay. So I got there or we got to the place we were eating at, which is Seoul Taco, spelled like Seoul as in like the city in Korea, South Korea, and not that the distinction matters. Anyway, we went to Seoul Taco, and I'd never been before, but I've been meaning to go for a while now, just to try it out, and it was good. And then they were like, okay, let's just go home. And by that, they meant like their home, where my sister's boyfriend and their friend, where they live and where my sister has been staying. So they all went. And I had to drive them, but it's like a 30-minute drive. And so, you know, we had taken all that time, and then, of course, you know, it was a 30-minute drive there. And then I had to drive for 30 minutes back. So it was like, man, I am getting nothing out of this. Not time, at least. It was quite a thing. And the worst part of it all, for sure, like none of that was really all that bad in and of itself. I would have gotten here on, you know, with a bit of time to stream, not a lot. And maybe if we had taken less time doing some of those things, or if I didn't have to drive them, I'd have more time to stream tonight. But a big thing that definitely got in the way was on my way back, I suddenly was feeling incredibly terrible in the gastrointestinal region. And I really, really, really had to poop, like really bad. And it was a 30-minute drive. I was not gonna make it. 15 minutes in for sure. I mean, like 10 minutes in to the 30-minute drive to home. Like I had already dropped them off, and I was driving back. And like 5 minutes, I was like, oh, I don't really feel that great. I hope this doesn't get worse. And then like 10 minutes in, I'm like, all right, this is bad. Let me see how long I can last. At 15 minutes, I was like, okay, I need to pull over somewhere. So I pulled over and made it to a QT and used the bathroom there and had to spend a good amount of time in that bathroom. Luckily, it was not a terrible bathroom. It was relatively clean and stuff. But man, it was not a good experience. And 100% it had to have been the Seoul Taco that I ate. So, for whatever reason, that was not great, but it is what it is. I'm okay now. I hope maybe it'll hit me again in, you know, like 30 minutes or something. We'll see. But, I think I'm feeling okay now. Alright, I'm gonna talk to you. But yeah, I got home and now I'm streaming, so yeah, that's the story. I gotta get back to the LFG. Okay, I'm here. Are we doing the cheese?
Nah, I'll show legit.
Okay. Just making sure.
It's worth it to at least have that in your back pocket if someone can't do the cheese.
Okay, are we doing, what are we doing for damage? Rockets or linears?
I said precision. It's just a bit easier on your own. Well, it works. Just you're said, welcome to use either, but
you said which one? Sorry,
linears.
Linears. Okay, cool. I am down. Finally, get a chance to try out the malfeasance
with the. Oh yes.
I don't even have the and catalyst. I just need.
Oh, the catalyst will help a bunch.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a free 20%. But...
and if you're a hunter, you put on lucky pants.
I assume that's why you're using it, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got to get the catalyst. I was just going to use it, and then I'm like, oh, wait, actually, it's going to be great on Shirochi, isn't it? Get all those
That's
crits.
Taken, yeah. So, well, and it's a taken enemy, so you get a slight bonus with that, too.
Also, is someone going to run... Oh, no, she's got a crit multiplier on her head. That's crazy.
You don't want to do div, yeah.
No div, then. Never mind. I mean, it would make it easier, but the damage would be worse, so.
Astro, did you say you need a bit of an explanation, at least, for some of it?
And Guardian,
I know Guardian does. Yeah. Okay. Basically, we have six symbols here in the center. We got two that are eight snake there, two that are Cloud Snake way over there, and two that are Infinity. We're going to find plates around the room that have one of those three symbols above them. So in this case, we have 8 Snake here. Don't get on it quite yet. It's divided into 3 sections. When you hop on, 2/3 of it are going to have a blight on it. The other one will be clear. Stand on the clear spot and repeat that 3 times till the blights explode. After 3 rounds, a knight will spawn on the plate, kill it, and head to middle because you're prepared for damage.
Yeah, pretty,
each of us will do one, though. And that will give us 1 door each to hide from a wipe attack. So when Callie teleports somewhere for damage, we'll be standing in the middle where she is. Underneath wherever she teleports to, there's going to be a set of doors. When it is time, it will say that she readies her weapon. So we will hide in the doors to avoid the wipe. Once it's done, we'll head back out, keep doing damage, and then hide in the next set if need be. And a 3rd time too if we need it.
No, makes sense. That's pretty easy.
It's pretty simple.
Yeah, it's nothing too crazy for her specifically.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, go ahead and find one of the plates.
Just do not rally. I'm sorry.
Oh no, that's okay.
Yeah, I didn't get on
the one that's the 2 snakes going downward. And any other one of those symbols though. Infinity, 8, or cloud.
What?
Oh, if Callie comes to visit you, make sure you shoot her a bit so she doesn't boop you off of your ping. Oh. That may have been what happened. I'll come get you in a second. Even if damage starts, just finish that plate and you'll be fine.
Yeah, I'm late to my plate.
Oh, I just saw Callie there. Again, once you're done, you can head to the middle and be ready for damage.
What happens when it spawns in the middle?
What do you mean when what spawns in the middle? The blight?
Yeah.
Oh, well, it'll be on 2/3 of it. I can't say which ones it might be in the middle. Yeah, so just go to the one that's not on. Yeah.
Yeah, I got it.
Jeez, Ravi.
All right. Shut up. She's moving mid.
Our damage is starting, so go ahead and hop on down.
Wait, can I...
Keep doing your plate, yeah. So that you have somewhere to hide. You may die for the first place, but you won't die for the next one, so.
I'm coming.
Alright, go ahead and hop in a door.
Come on.
One in each.
Oh, I got it!
Wait, where's the open one?
We might not
kill your knight over there?
Gotten all the knights, yeah.
Yeah, I did.
Well, that probably was just, like, yeah, a bit too late to take effect for that round. Alright, one more hide here. Make sure you get... underneath where she is, not the side we just did.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're good.
I haven't done this in a minute.
You're good.
We're probably still going to kill her here, so don't worry about it.
Oops, I didn't mean to do that.
There we go.
Yeah, we're good.
Oh, I got coordination of the beast. Let's go!
Yeah, I think the hardest part about learning this raid is, like, how easy it is to kill everything. So, like, there's a lot of room for error, and
yeah.
it's almost too forgiving of a raid these days. So it might take a few, like, full completions to really understand what's going on sometimes.
Yeah, some of the mechanics as you get later on can be very confusing, but having someone explain them definitely helps. Well, to figure them out, yeah, it's a project.
Oh my god.
Just follow the leader.
Keep following me, dude.
Yeah.
We'll have a secret chest right away, which is definitely worth grabbing because resets tomorrow. I doubt you'll do it again.
Or you could.
Oh, no. A little too far. Whoops.
No. Well, Secret Chance is going to be off this edge here.
Just some gauntlets. Not a good roll, is it? Pretty terrible.
Awesome.
Oh shit, I got another red border.
Hey!
I got a red border apex.
Oh hell yeah.
That's the red border you want.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of want to go on the hand cannon.
I did actually do the fusion first, and I kind of regret that now because I haven't even leveled it up at all. And I've been dying to get the apex.
Oh, whoops.
I just chose not to farm though on the first week of the season. I was lazy.
Whoa. Okay.
Connor, do you know where to go?
You see where I
went? Yeah, there's like a little thing they have to step on. Yeah.
I've been consistently forgetting to ask people if they want the Wishender eggs. It's a little late for that now.
I already got it.
Okay, yeah.
I already got it. I'm good. Thanks, so.
Well, it's we have to activate a wish, so it'd be too late, but...
I feel like I was seeing a... Aren't snipers really good on Cali or something? Like,
anything that's precision can be decent, but... Snipers just aren't... in the meta right now.
Yeah, I mean,
don't
dude shot damage. Like 36 shots at him. I don't remember what fucking sniper it was.
Oh, that's that's the sniper for the Supremacy.
Oh, okay.
I would not say it's meta. It's definitely decent.
For snipers, it's not terrible, but it's just, again, no. Snipers aren't super meta right now.
They're just not, yeah. That's the unfortunate part. For this encounter, you're just going to want fast burst damage. Slugs, rockets, linears can still work. Really up to you.
I'm using Trinity Ghoul.
I hope that's not for damage.
Robbie, no. What, Connor?
What's just
a hidden meta, don't worry about it.
Use your auto rifle. If you're using, are you using arc?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Use that, and then like.
Do you have any kind of rocket or something?
Yeah.
You can just throw it on. It doesn't need to be that top tier. It's not a ridiculous encounter by any means. Also, I'm gonna put on taken spec on a few things before I forget. To assist with explaining for some of this, if you want to hop up on this rock over here, get a nice peek at the encounter before it actually starts. Fuck.
Fucking I hate these rocks.
I know.
Oh, that's for shit. I was gonna say maybe I could grab a checkpoint while you're explaining it.
You want the Shiro checkpoint?
Kinda, yeah.
Well, it's a little late now that we all got up here.
Yeah, it's fine.
But you can grab it after if you want to. It's fine.
It's fine.
Don't forget about D2 checkpoints as well.
Also, I mean,
they also end tomorrow. It literally ends tomorrow.
And it ends tomorrow, yeah. And there is a wish wall, you're right. There's a lot of ways to get it, but yeah, it won't be worth it right now necessarily. Anyways, there's going to be 6 total damage phases. For this encounter, each phase is going to be in a location like this with 3 plates, and Shirachi will be standing in the middle. When we kill all the ads, there will be a relic for everyone to pick up, or one person on each plate to pick up. Once all three have been picked up, you and everyone will count down from three and hop on together, because these plates do damage you over time, so you want to just be getting on at the same time. You're then going to shoot the person to your right with the beam, and then you will make a full triangle around Shirochi, and that will bring down her shields and you can do damage. So we'll do that to start, kill a bunch of adds in between, do a second phase, and then we're going to reach a room that looks like this one over here. Do not hop on the plates in this room. The other ones are fine, but these ones you don't want to. It'll lock you out from using these during the encounter, at least for our next attempt. So we have a grid of 3x3 with plates, and we have three blank symbols on the wall. The left symbol is going to be first, so this one over there. You'll see how it's kind of faintly broken into 9 different segments, like a tic-tac-toe board. Yeah, they're very faint, but they're there. 4 of the 9 are going to be shaded dark, and we're going to have to stand on the plates that match those 3 that are dark. So during the encounter, you won't be able to use that plate there, Kenshi's, but yeah, that's fine. I don't know why it activated twice, it's actually weird. Anyways, you're going to get on the 4 plates that it shows are shaded dark. For example, bottom left corner is going to be this plate here. Middle right one, which is that one there, will be the plate there, and so on. Once all 4 are on, again, you're going to want to say 3, 2, 1, because they do damage you. The symbol will accept, and we'll move on to the middle one. Our perspective will shift to this area here, so the bottom side is now these 3 plates here. So we'll solve it from there. And then once we get to the third one, our perspective shifts once more, with the bottom now being these 3 here. Get on all 4, these platform thingies come down, and we can jump up to the next floor.
And they turn.
Yeah, if you stand in the dead center for a second, even a split second, they'll start to rotate like that.
Yeah, so if you're able
to be wary of that, it's annoying.
Try to hang on the edges of it for the sake of your teammates.
I fuck it up constantly, so it's not the end of the world. It's very sensitive with that, so. Sound good enough, though?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's going to be a little bit of a sense of urgency. There's a timer that counts down for each floor, and then when we're doing damage to the boss, there's going to be a segment that we got to do within a certain... The moment damage phase unlocks on each plate, we gotta, like, try to shred her as fast as we can. So have something that's decent for burst damage, but also, like, you know, try not to run out of ammo.
Oh yeah, that reminds me, there is gonna be a weird blight-like ball on the ground called a Taken Essence. Don't worry about that for this encounter, we're not gonna use it. It's used to extend the damage phase, but it will cause more confusion than needs to. And you can very much get all of the phases in time, so it's not much of a worry.
Yeah, I would say.
So just don't bother picking it up. If you hold on to it for too long, you can, but oftentimes people don't listen to that and keep running around with it and then they just die. Because it does kill you if you hold it for too long.
Yeah, the Taken Essence does come in later. But we can get the explanation at that point. But
yeah, we'll cross that bridge
then. It's a recurring thing within the raid, and yet like you only really need it one time. That's like it. Every other time you can just ignore it, so it's weird.
There's means to bypass it in most cases, yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Good?
Let's do it. Everybody get close to the door.
You all may be quite familiar with this for kill farming.
Yeah.
It's a great place to do catalysts, level up weapons, shit like that.
Come on, let me
crack
my fucking... There we go.
Oops. Alright, we got the 3 relics.
Wait.
Pick one up.
The fuck?
Hop on and shoot them to the right.
Nice.
Yeah, there we go, go for damage.
Why did I use that?
Oh my god, I'm so used to doing this with a demolitionist rocket.
What the fuck?
Oh, Guardian, press your grenade, just get rid of that.
Oh. Yeah.
That's the thing you don't want to pick up, it just causes problems for this. But you didn't cause any problems there, don't worry. You can just ignore the buff. If you're curious though, it drops from the Taken Captains, the Solar Shield orange bar guys.
Oh god.
All right, we got more things to pick up.
Oh shit.
Go ahead. This is. Oh shit. You might be able to get it in time still.
No.
Okay, everyone off. Everyone off. Yeah, just.
Wait, what was I supposed to grab?
You don't need. If we just need three people doing
just,
it.
Yeah, so just do it. Uh-oh. You guys gotta get.
Yeah, if you don't have it, the thing that they're all shooting the beam from, it's like a little. Taken looking nut.
My bad. I picked it up and like somehow boot myself off of it.
Oh, we gotta hurry here. Okay, there we go.
Nice. Alright, we're at the first puzzle room. I'll get the bottom middle. So all the middle ones are just kind of nice. I'll put mine here.
Alright, left middle.
Alright, jump on.
If there's a well for to heal you, you may hop on early, yeah. There we go.
Wait.
Next one, I'll get... Oh, get off there, Guardian, since you've already been on it. Yeah. I'll get bottom right.
I'll get bottom right. Middle.
Alright, go ahead and hop on. Okay. I will do bottom right again.
I'll do top right, because I don't think I can do top left.
Hop on. And there's the thing. You see how that worked, Guardian? That makes sense?
Yeah.
Okay. Hopefully you can help with the next one. Yeah. Just take initiative, call it out if you want to take one.
Yeah.
It's a bit rough to like try and get you to do things then, because it is a time crunch.
No, I understood it though.
Ooh, sun bracers would be fun.
Yep, I'm using that. Mostly because I just want to get my well back, but... Everyone can grab a thing. There you go.
Connor, you want to grab one? Okay, never mind.
No, it's fine.
Alright. No, my rocket missed. Fuck. Go, 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 go. Okay.
Fuck. Right.
I need this heavy. That's okay. If you're going to do a super, you want to do it right away.
Yeah.
But you're good. Alright, I'll get middle right. Someone get top right?
I'll get top right.
Yeah. Hello, phalanx, please don't.
I got bottom middle.
I got right middle. Go ahead and... Oh, someone else take astro spot.
Alright, damn. Yeah, better die.
This one.
I'll take it for you. Oh shit, no! Yeah, someone I split right off. Middle? Someone get bottom can? Middle, someone get right. Someone get middle middle, someone get bottom middle. Astro, you've already been on one, so hop off, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Go, go, go. Okay,
we're good.
Okay, we got it, barely. That's okay, it was scuffed, but it's fine.
My bad.
I can get left.
I'll get bottom middle. I can't do any others.
Again. I'll do right
jump
middle.
On, jump on.
Oh, Kaiser, get off.
Please. Yeah. I'm dead.
Someone take Astro's spot, because you already went on it.
Okay. It's the same platform you can't jump on more than once.
We got it,
Oh, shit. Oh, no.
No, someone take left wing.
Oh, dude. Yeah, that's wiped.
Dude, I got booped by the fucking...
Yeah.
Phalanx.
Is someone able to get top?
Can someone get on that?
Oh.
Is someone able to... Oh, no. Is someone able to get the left?
I don't think I can.
This one?
Shit. Yeah, no, we're dead.
Yeah,
damn it. Sorry.
Okay, so make sure if you've been on one,
rotate.
Do not get on it again. Yeah.
Yeah.
And Don't jump on prematurely, yeah.
So, an easy way
unless you have
can...
means of healing yourself.
Yeah.
Blocking with a sword does work, too.
I'd like to recommend an easy way to keep track where we can just assign everybody numbers.
Yeah.
Do we want to
Yeah, we can do that, yeah. Let me just put on...
Because, you know, we tried Chaos Strat, and now they get the idea, and now we can do...
Mm-hmm.
You know, numbers, and they can get the full experience.
Yeah. So you're going to read those from left to right when we number them. So the farthest, or it'll be like the top left corner, then top middle, top right, middle left, middle right, and so on. So one will pick up the first one in that order, and two gets the second, three, four.
Like that, if you can see the text chat.
Yeah, that's the order of the... Yeah, the stupid slash help for available commands appeared in the middle for me, but
I see. It's like a you know like a phone like a digital phone.
So if you want to step on those plates, yeah. If you want to step on those plates, call a number.
Okay.
Or even we can say.
Well, I just if anyone wants to, I want them to do it. But
yeah, I think it's less about numbering the plates and more assigning. Like roles, we could do that also, where we have four people set to do plates, and three of them are the same people who do the laser.
That's what I was thinking of. Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's the way most.
Do we want to try that and just have those four people pick a number?
Sure. Wait. So the four people who do the laser are doing it.
Yeah. So they're going to
do the laser, and someone else will do the puzzles.
I'll do one and two.
So you're just gonna pick one number, and you're gonna be one.
If you're one, you're gonna pick the lowest number out of the pattern that he showed you. That's shaded out essentially. So if the top middle two is shaded out, but one isn't, you'll be taking two. If none are shaded till four, you take four.
Yeah. Okay.
So you'll be one. I'll take two. Astra, you want anything?
Yeah, I'll take three, I guess.
And I'll take four.
Yeah.
That works out, so you guys can get practice with the laser too. Yeah, that works.
Sounds good.
Oh, a little bit closer, guys.
Oh, no, Kenshi's just up in the heavens.
Where is he?
He was very high up. Here he is. Damn it, more ads. Go ahead and grab him, yep. All right, two ready?
Four ready?
One ready.
Two, one.
Okay. Nice. Two's ready.
Four is ready. You're at the wrong one, Astro.
Oh, shit.
Three, two, hop one, go on.
Awesome. Two and three switch. I can't take it.
Okay.
Three, all two, right. One, jump on.
Hop on. Wait, someone get the top middle?
Yeah, we don't need that one. Oh. That's okay.
But you're good.
Shit. We're good, we're good.
Dude, remember the perspective changes with everyone we do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Good though.
Oh, damn. Let me up.
Oh.
They rotated. Yeah. Sorry about that. Like I said, it's so hard to. It's so easy to accidentally do it. Nice.
Whoops.
On special.
Careful.
Cabin, yep.
Damn.
Yeah. Damn. Well, another puzzle room here. Got him, good. Two's ready.
Three's ready.
Four's ready. Three, two, one. Oh, dupe. Not that one.
Wait.
Oh, I'm dupe. We're looking at the symbol on the left there. See, the one. Now we're looking at the middle symbol.
Yeah.
See how there's some missing there? Yeah.
Fuck.
Three's ready.
Two's ready.
You got his rest? Four's ready. Three, two, one. Jump on.
Hop on. Okay. Last symbol. Two's
can
good.
Can someone do it for me? I'm kind of confused.
Yeah, no, you're
look
good.
At, look at the painting that's missing see, stuff. You want to look
the
at
right
that.
Side of the room.
Three's ready.
Oh.
Four's ready. Three, two, one, go.
Looking directly at it from that perspective, those are the ones we need.
Somebody take over for Astro.
I accidentally jumped on it twice, I guess.
Yeah, someone's going to have to take Carnum's as well, because I couldn't.
I can take this one.
Oh, I can't get that one either.
I can get the middle one.
Dupe, you get off two. Car, you have to take the middle one.
I'm going to die.
Someone get the top. Oh, shit.
Maybe I can get that one. No, I've done this one.
Might be
okay, everyone off, everyone off. Just everyone get off.
Right. Try to take one that you haven't taken. Middle. I think I can do left middle. Okay, never mind.
Someone's able to take bottom right, please?
Yeah.
Get top middle. I can't do bottom
okay. Right. Good.
There we go, we're good.
We got it.
Okay.
Woo! Keep going up. Sorry, dupe, it's hard to explain in the moment.
Yeah, this is like the only part. I'm
running double special. Oh, I can't shoot at something to show you anything.
You gotta look at the portrait that's missing stuff, and you just gotta match what's missing. That's all you're doing.
And again, from the perspective, looking directly at it is where you're doing it, yeah. I think you had the plates. Ooh. You're looking from the wrong way, essentially.
Hmm.
All right, hop on.
Oh, shit.
Literally running double slug right now.
Killer.
Go, go, go. Nice. Another red border. Let's go.
Damn. Got nothing red border yet.
Oh, I'm getting very lucky. You saved my sister. Thank you. Grab is heavy. Your desires could feed a nation. Fucking six sword swings, goddammit.
You say walk down the stairs, you mean like literally?
Oh my god, just drop down, Astra.
Don't get baited so easy, please.
Bro.
Oh, I missed.
Wait, what the?
You gotta go up the tree.
That part's not a troll.
Yeah, they...
Fuck.
I'm gonna take them the less annoying way to the chest.
Dude, I just got like regular boots. Like world drop.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
From the chest?
Yeah. But I got boots of the great hunt.
Oh no, that's the raid armor.
It is?
It's not very cool, yeah.
Dude, what? I totally just went the wrong way.
You're good. I'm gonna head back to help Guardian find the chest too.
Yeah.
The tree sucks.
Fuck. It does. Controller sucks.
It's a bit easier to jump up to this branch here. There's this behind you, kinda. Here, turn around, Guardian. A little bit more.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, come up. Yeah, it's a bit easier to go to there and then up to here.
Okay.
Yeah. And we'll grab the secret chest for you as well. This is the only raid still in the game now. The secret chests do not give you only loot you have. They can actually give you anything. Oh. Go up another level. Oh, just up another level, yeah. Right there. See it straight in?
Yeah.
And just head back the way we came.
Okay.
Good lord, you were floating so damn slow at the end. Have fun with this part.
Can't see.
No, you can't. That's kind of the point. If it just to rotate.
Okay.
That should be enough. We'll go here. This is a tiny thing. Forgot. Oh, I jumped to that really late. This probably wasn't smart. No, I'm okay.
That was literally close. Right on the edge. That was so close.
Oh. Good, do not, don't revive yourself.
Okay.
You'll go all the way back, so it's just not worth it. When I was still here. That way.
That way?
Yep. It's sketchy as hell in here, yeah.
Wait,
hop on that spinning guy there.
This one?
Yeah. And then keep running straight up into the next spinning one.
Okay.
Uh-oh. Dude, oh, okay, yeah, I'm retreating to get you here.
Yeah, no. What armor set is that?
It's armor?
Yeah,
it's the Couturier armor from a few seasons back. You can get in the store.
Which one?
Dude, he looks like a civilian. He just looks...
It is like really basic looking. Civilian. Oh, go ahead and follow me here, Guardian.
Got some nice shiny boots. Dude, you should get... Only if you had the cowboy hat helmet. Like, that would look good.
I do, but it's
thank God for hunters being able to get height.
This this helmet makes the hood of your cloak disappear, so the cowboy hat would just not be there.
Oh yeah.
There you go.
All right. Oh.
What? Oh, okay. You died in here though.
He may have gotten eager edged off the edge.
Oh yeah. Okay, I see. Rockets again work well here. Linears can work. You just want more burst damage. He's not a hard boss. Very squishy.
So we're doing... Which one are we doing? Linears?
I'm going to use a rocket, but I don't care what you use. You don't need to have a strategy going into this.
Yeah, really.
Oh, I got Bane Switch and Tracking Module on my Apex.
Hey, that's not bad.
That's not bad. I'm going to use it.
For fucking final boss of the new dungeon. That's good.
Yeah.
Right. Typically, you want reconstruction, but
yeah,
there's times, like I said, retracking is good. So how this encounter is going to work, this orb right up here, don't jump into it quite yet, but that is called a Taken Strength. We're going to need to pick up 10 of those to get to damage trace. When you pick up one, you'll receive a debuff called Taken Strength. If you pick up two of them, you'll have Taken Strength times 2. However, if you pick up a third, you will die, so only pick up 2 at max. After you pick up this first one, there's going to be some adds, and then 2 strengths spawn on the left and 2 on the right. Everyone will pick those up. After that, Morgeth is then going to detain somebody. It'll be whoever has the most strengths. If people are tied for the most, then it'll be 50-50 who gets it. Or however many are tied. You know what I mean. You'll pick somebody. If you get detained, you're going to need to call out where you are. A person that has 0 taken strengths is going to pick up a taken essence, that buff I told you not to pick up last encounter. We want to pick it up here. You're going to pick that up, run over to the guy who is detained, get close to them, and press your grenade button. That will cleanse them from the detain and transfer their 2 strengths onto you. That is why you want to have 0 going into it, because if you have more, you're dead. After that, the person who was just freed will commonly be the next person to free the guy from the detain, because they're at 0 now. Just makes it easier. So after that first detain, more spawn, pick him up, free the second guy. And after that is done, the strength will respawn right here, and that'll be our 10th one. Once picked up, damage starts, so we'll head behind Morgeth and go from there. Does that make enough sense?
Yeah, are we all doing this one?
Everyone's gonna participate here, yeah.
Yeah. So, to the new guys, have any of you guys done Vow of the Disciple?
Yes.
No.
So, if you have, you know the Taken relic from that.
Third encounter.
It's the same thing, is that. That's where that relic comes from.
Gotcha.
So, like, if you're used to the controls for that, it's the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Sound good? I'll take the first cleanse, and again, whoever's after that will take the next. Whoever I cleanse will be the next, I mean. Sound good?
Gotcha.
Okay. Yeah. Whenever you're ready, pick up that blade then, or the strength in the middle. I can't do it because I'm doing the first cleanse.
I'll do it.
Okay. Keep in mind, you do need to jump into them. Don't just stand underneath it. Lots of people do that.
Where do you at?
Kill the adds and then we'll get them, so don't worry yet. And I didn't take note. What was the challenge for the week?
I have no idea.
I don't expect you to pay attention to that either.
Forever Fight.
Oh, Forever Fight? That's Riven, right?
I think so.
Awesome.
There's one on me.
Wait, I don't want... How much taken strength do I not want? Oh,
two. Three will kill you. Two is good.
Three will kill you. Two is fine.
Oh.
Should I not pick this one up then? Or should I pick up my first one?
Yeah, go ahead and pick up your first.
Oh, never mind.
No, pick up until you have two.
Trapped on right. Guardian is trapped on right.
Yeah. What the fuck was that? I just got one shot, pretty much. I'm sorry. I'm coming.
Wait, why am I trapped?
I'm gonna free you.
You grabbed two strength, which is normal, and then it randomly chose you.
So, Guardian, do not pick up any more strengths now.
Yeah.
Okay, the buff
so is... when, you see that icon over on the left side of the map? The counting down? Don't pick it up yet, but after we pick up the second round of strengths, you're gonna pick that up and head to the... Oh, wait, Morgoth is... We might want to wipe. He's kind of gaining some strength. Okay, go pick that up, Guardian. And run up to, well, over to here to Kenshi's now.
Kenshi's. Yeah, go to Kenshi's.
Right here, back towards spawn.
Connor, this way. Connor.
Back towards spawn here.
Connor.
Run up to Kenshi's and oh shit, was that actually that long? Let's just wipe and reset it.
Yeah.
He's gonna be in a lot of strength and we may not get him now, so just go ahead. Yeah. So when you pick that up, the person who's detained will die after a little while, so you do need to be quick with it. Run up to them and press grenade, that's it. You'll take their strengths from them and they'll be freed.
Okay.
You got detained the first time, so that's why I ran up to you with it and cleansed you.
Yeah.
That may not happen again.
Okay.
Not a chance. And make sure you do not pick up more than two as well.
Yeah.
If you die, they respawn, and that's when he starts gaining strength, so it means less damage time. And you technically can end the phase early, but nobody does that, because he does not have much health.
Everyone ready?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Yeah,
so just, you know, try not to hesitate too much.
Yeah.
Don't be scared to pick up
tickets. Again, it may not be you again, Guardian, so don't worry yet.
Okay.
Now I gotta check which challenge that is. I feel like it might have been Shirochi, but I don't remember. No, Colosseum Champion is Shirochi, so it is Riven. Awesome. That's a free one, then.
Here,
pick up the strengths. There's one on right side still.
I got it.
Oh.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, I'm... Dupestar's trapped.
Up, I see you. So, Dupe, you're going to cleanse the next guy, so don't take any more.
Okay.
And don't pick up the buff yet, but you'll pick it up when someone gets detained.
Okay.
That one may run out, so be ready to take another, kill another captain if need be.
Okay.
Oh, don't pick up that by accident.
Oh my god.
Can someone get these ones on right?
Should I grab
Fire
it?
I can get only one.
Go ahead and grab it now, dude. Someone get this other one on right. Run over, please.
I can get it.
So we don't, anybody so we don't lose.
I'm coming.
I'm detained in middle, yeah, so you could come get me. Okay, everyone get ready for damage now. When this last guy appears, here we go. Head behind Morgoth. Let's go.
Kill him.
There we go.
You know, I think they,
as I said, pretty easy.
I think they've kind of curated the drops. Like, I don't have red border of the sniper, and I keep getting drops of the sniper.
Oh,
Dude, I keep getting armor.
They're not red border, but it's still dropping me just the sniper and nothing else. So it's like, it's weird. Like, the game knows that that's what I want, but I don't know.
It's teasing you.
It's weird.
You can still get double drops from the quest, right? Like, they're patching that this next week, right?
Yes, yeah. They specifically said
that was half the reason I wanted to get it done.
Yeah. I've been putting it off all weekend.
Fucking well skin.
You kid. Oh, fuck, I also forgot to ask if people had glittering keys they want to use. God damn it.
Did we put in the wish?
I think I do, but...
No. That's why I'm upset, because it's too late. Just 1 in 3 to give people the free ethereal key and emblem.
Yeah, I mean, well, sucks to suck.
Yeah. For the people learning, this room that we entered here with all the statues, we will return here. I won't say why, but we will return here. If you're the one here, you just need to remember that you're going up the stairs and placing something in this little divot here, okay? Not the side with the statues, go the opposite of them. Yeah, I'm not giving you context now because it's kind of cool to see it. When it comes.
That's later.
Yeah. I just like to make sure people are aware because that I've had many wipes to people not figuring out where to go in that room.
Gotcha.
For this encounter, you just want to add clear. There will be some fairly beefy knights that will spawn. So something to take care of them is recommended, but...
Do you think I would be able to add clear?
If you don't want to do anything, sure, yeah.
Not really.
Fair enough. This was the one day one teams definitely got stuck on. I mean, Riven was too, but only a few people actually made it to that, so.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I forgot. Forgot about Riven.
Definitely a challenge herself, but not the way we're going to do it, so.
Yeah.
All right, the explanation for this is going to sound pretty scary. once you see it, it makes a hell of a lot of sense. So we're going to have 3 people that are going to start the encounter by standing on these plates. We have one in front of each room. Each of these rooms is going to have a name as well. The one right here and the plate outside of it is going to be called Stairs. The one to the left and the plate in front of it is going to be called Tree, and the one to the right with the plate in front of it will be called Rock.
Which is pretty self-explanatory.
Yeah, you should be able to figure that out.
Yeah.
Like I said, one person gets on each plate, and then each person on the plates will see 3 symbols. One on the left, one in the middle, one on the right, all next to each other. The guy in the middle is going to say what their middle symbol is. To call them out, make sure you say the type of animal, direction it is facing, and if you can, something distinct about it. Like if it's breathing fire, holding a spear, swimming in a circle, something like that. Distinct about it. And again, what it is, where it's going. There's a lot that are very similar, so you just want to be specific. Once called, trees and rocks, one of them will have that symbol out of their 3 as well, and it will be on their left or their right. If it is on their left side, let's say Rocks has it on their left, whatever symbol was called, that means Rock Plate is going to be Penumbra. So in the chat, I will type RP for Rock Penumbra. After we figure out the first one, in my example is Rock, they will say their middle symbol. It's a Stripper Dragon. So then Trees will have it, let's say, on their right side. That makes Tree Plate and Tumbra. We do have to use these words, unfortunately. So I will type in the chat for Tree and Tumbra, T-A. We can always figure out Stairs by process of elimination, so we don't need to do it, but if you were to, Trees would say their middle symbol, Stairs would say where it is. It's on the left, Pen, right, and Tumbra. Once that's done, one of the three rooms is going to be open. The other two will be blocked by a taken wall. Let's say stairs is open first, so the guy in charge of stairs will enter the room, find a taken captain, kill it, and pick up the taken essence, the cleansing thing from last encounter. Their door to their room will then close. They're going to be told which room is open. If Rox is open, they're going to take the path over here to the right so they can get around and back out to the middle. If it's trees, they'll take the path to the left, loop around and get back to the middle. Just go in the direction of whatever's called so you can get out. And once you are out, you're going to tell us what your buff is. It's going to say on the left side, take an essence penumbra or antumbra. If it's penumbra, you dunk on a penumbra plate. If it's antumbra, you dunk on antumbra. So let's say the guy on the stairs picked it up. They see it's penumbra and they're running over to Rox. When they come out, they will dunk on the rock plate because they have penumbra and Rox is penumbra. Rox is now the open room, so they'll have a captain pick up their essence, run over to trees, come out. Let's say they have penumbra again. Rox has already been dunked on and cleansed, so we know it can't be Rox. And we know that trees is antumbra, so that means stairs has to be penumbra. So in that case, that person would dunk on stairs. Trees would be the last to run, they come out of stairs, and they'll dunk theirs on tree, because that's the only one that hasn't been cleansed yet. And we repeat that three times, reading new symbols in between.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not the nicest explanation out there. It's pretty daunting. Would you like to try those mechanics?
I mean, I'll give it a go, why not?
All right, I encourage it, because people put it off forever and never learn how to do it.
Yeah, let's do
it. Guardian, you want to as well?
Not right now.
Okay, that's fine.
No,
I can read.
Yeah. Kenshi's, do you want to read? Or it's kind of weird without your mic. I don't want it to clog up the chat, but you're welcome to if you want. Okay, you can. And everyone else, your job is going to be kill adds, and if you see a yellow bar knight running towards one of the middle plates, use everything you can. Use your heavy, your super, whatever. Kill it. Because if it gets to that middle plate and stands there for too long, it will wipe us. So please kill them. And each time an essence is picked up, one, two, or three will spawn, getting progressively more each round. Astra, you want to try reading stairs so you just can kind of go first?
Or, okay.
Yeah. Cool.
Can you go over just the reading and nothing else real quick?
Yeah. So stairs will always read their middle symbol first. So you're going to say name of the creature, direction it's facing, what it's doing or holding or whatever. Once said, rocks or trees will say, I have it on my left or right. If it's on the left, their plate is penumbra. If it's on the right, their plate's antumbra. Regardless of what it is, I'll type it in the chat. Whichever plate called it will read their middle symbol. Whoever has it will say it's on their left or right. We'll type that in the chat as well. And if we want to, we can do one more reading and that'll tell us what stairs is. But you don't always need to do that, because like I said, you can use process of elimination.
Okay.
So for you, just mostly worry about that middle symbol. We can do the third round of reading to just kind of get you used to it if you want. Actually, no. You do rocks plate. You actually get to do everything then. Yeah. Car, you can take mid.
Is it cool if I actually take one of the sides? I always do mid whenever I do this encounter. I want to shake it up a little bit.
Okay. That's all right. And she's, you want to take mid then? Yeah.
Awesome. I appreciate it. Yeah. I've done this encounter quite a few different times, but only recently actually started doing any of the reading, so.
Fair enough. Like I said, it's a scary thing. If you don't learn it, it's hard to actually learn it at some point.
Yeah.
Because you're just expected to know.
It's just been like one of those things where, you know, I haven't had a good explanation of it really, so I've just had to piece it together slowly.
Yeah, it's pretty rough to do that. There is logical meaning behind the words as well, but I'll spare you that explanation.
Yeah, that's...
Astrology shit, actually.
Yeah, I had somebody who's supposed to be teaching one time, and they started every single time, they started their explanation with what the definitions of penumbra and antumbra were. And I'm like, okay, I get it. I understand that part. What I want to know is how to play the video game.
Yeah.
Like, what is... Yeah.
Oh... And Astro, are you clear on how the running will work too? Because you will do that as well. Yeah, I'd encourage it at least.
So I jump in there, I kill the whatever.
Your captain,
knight,
yeah.
Knight, captain, whatever, take his buff, and then I run out to the door that's whoever tells me whichever one's open.
And there is a path directly to trees. It's around the corner. Often people miss it. Just keep that in mind. Don't go the long way. Take the short one.
Yeah, each room connects to both of the other rooms.
Yeah.
So try to just hear for the call. And everybody else, just try to call out what room you see open once...
when it changes like that, yeah.
Once they pick up the buff, call out what room is open.
And once I'm out, I just dunk on my plate,
pretty much. Dunk on whatever your buff matches. So again, your buff will say take an essence, penumbra, ant umbra.
Oh, yeah. Gotcha.
We'll put it on a pen plate if it's pen, ant if it's ant.
Gotcha. Yeah.
It's, and again, it'll all be typed.
Chat. Yeah, it'll be in chat. So like, if it's rocks, it's R. And if it's trees, it's T. And then penumbra and ant umbra are depending on what buff you get. That's what the PNA stand for. So
okay, cool.
I always do the rooms capital and A or P lowercase as well. I don't know, that helps people sometimes. So I don't know.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
Oh,
right. Give it a shot. Is there somebody ad clearing left? Or ad clearing trees, I mean?
Yeah. The...
okay.
Cool. I guess I'll take a rock and guardian. You can take stair.
Yeah.
And you don't need to be in the room. Just watch for the knights coming out the middle.
Yeah, just stay out of the room.
They will walk through the walls, so.
Yeah, they will, but you won't. So watch out.
Yeah.
You gotta kill them before they get to the plate. And so it's usually better to be on the inner room.
Yeah.
So. All right. I'm going to stand on my plate. Everybody ready?
Yep.
Let's do it.
And Kenji's just going to be typing the first, so just keep that in mind. Look for that.
Dragon left is me. That's on my right. So tree's right.
Okay, what's your middle then, tree? Yeah.
Fish jumping out of the water, facing up.
That's on where's my left.
Where's that? Right. You're on your left. Cool. Yeah. You may hop off the plates and rocks your first. So hop in there, find the captain. He doesn't spawn right away, so give him a moment.
Whoa.
And I can't tell you where you're running yet. Wait, you can actually tell, but on the what?
Well, it's not the current one, so. And it's probably. Well, no, sometimes it is where you're going.
Pick that up. Stairs is open. Stairs is open.
Yeah, stairs is open.
I have ant umbra, so.
Fair enough.
You have ants, so yeah, you're gonna dunk on the tree.
Gotcha.
Can choose, yep. Awesome. I didn't think there was a way you could predict the first one, so I was pretty baffled when you said that.
okay.
I assume then that Kenshi's aware trees is you're running to. Other way, Kenshi's.
Trees is open now. Trees is open.
Yep.
Go clockwise. Watch the knights, guys.
I missed my rocket. I got him. Oh my god. No.
And obviously don't kill it till he's out of the room. I didn't say that, but don't kill your captain till the runner's out. And you know where you're going, I assume? Yep. Car heading to your
Yep, I'm going in. Clear stuff.
I was gonna say if you weren't sure you're doing both things.
Oh good.
Running to rocks, obviously, too.
Yeah. I am it's the last one, so
other way, actually, it doesn't. Yeah, just don't kill the captain in there, Astro. You're not gonna run again.
Oh, okay. Wow, just
if you do, it'll. Never mind.
No, I said rocks. Yeah. I hope it said rocks at least.
We got time. It's fine.
Yeah, you do. You have time though. That's the question.
What? Where am I dunking? I'm sorry.
Stairs is left. Stairs is last. Yeah.
Cool.
There you go. All right, hop on your plates again. We're gonna read.
Same thing as before.
Yep. Obviously different results. Why is it not stopping?
Something went wrong.
I'm gonna die.
Oh, shit! I didn't tell you how to dunk, Astro. You need to press your grenade when you're on the plate.
Oh, shit.
Go to whatever plate you're supposed to go to and press grenade on it.
No, I'm gonna book it and see if we somehow can make it.
There's no way. There's all security.
I absolutely forgot to tell you that. That's my bad.
I thought I got it off.
No, the door's closed! I went the wrong way, I'm stupid.
My bad.
I could have saved it there too. So.
Yeah, so if you've done Vow, it's the same as Cleansing the Blights.
Yeah.
In that.
I think what happened was, yeah, I have my charged grenade and my non-charged grenade on two different keybinds, so I think I have to press my charged grenade. Maybe that's what I did wrong.
Charged and
not charged and uncharged.
You mean melee? Because you need grenade, not melee.
Melee, excuse me.
Oh yeah, you should be pressing grenade for it. Yeah.
Why didn't it go off for me?
I think it's 76.
Just make sure you don't do your super.
Yeah, gotcha.
Because the super is used to extend phases for bosses. The grenade's used to cleanse.
Alright, let's do it.
Okay.
Again, same deal. Jesus Christ.
Again, it's also on my right again. Fish swimming in a circle on its own.
That's on my left side.
Okay. You're ready to run. Don't know where yet. Rocks is first. Okay.
Yeah. We got tarp again, so we'll see.
Yeah.
I wonder if that means stairs is going to be open again. We'll find out, I guess.
I haven't found these. Yeah, I haven't found true patterns in this, so maybe.
Or we might get crazy lucky and it might just trick us by opening stairs.
Yeah, who knows?
So
there's really no good way to test
the other
it.
Thing?
You're running the trees,
trees.
Pick it up, Aster. Pick up the thing. Jeez. You picked up the tangle. You picked up the tangle.
Oh.
Run back to it. Run back. Don't kill your captain car right away, yeah.
There we go.
There you go.
And some brew.
They look the same. I don't blame you for that. They look pretty similar.
It's an Antumbra, so you dunk at trees. So
my screen.
Yeah.
Exit trees and dunk there.
By the way, you can shoot with the weapon with that thing to kill the phalanx if you need.
Yeah, okay. I kind of got stuck on him for a second. All right, so I'm dunking.
Stand on the tree plate and press grenade. Perfect.
Got it. Okay.
You're running the stairs as well, yeah.
I am Penumbra. So rocks then.
Yep.
You can kill your knight and move on. That's stairs.
Head towards rocks as well. Rocks. Rock. Yeah. And yeah, stairs is left. So.
Exit rocks. Dunk at stairs. Dunk at stairs. Don't get stairs.
Awesome. Read again. This time it actually finished. What is it? Oh, fish seaweed?
That's me. It's on my left for trees.
Yep.
My middle is kissing snakes.
That's on my right side.
Damn.
We got rat pee.
Okay. Stairs, you're first. Don't know where you're running. Also, it being trees open first last time confirmed that there is no pattern, I think.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Just unfortunate, man. I love looking for that type of shit, so I've been looking for a while.
There might be something where if you look at the clockwork of it all.
Oh, that's true, right? Yeah.
I don't know, but.
You're running to rocks. Because I know the words come from the shadows. The shadows probably can say more, so.
Do you have Penrant?
He knows where to go, I think. Trees is Pen, rocks is Ant, so wherever you need.
Can't you sell it? I'm like, that's right.
Yeah. Oh, shit! Okay, that's why I have a Nova Bomb.
So, rocks, go ahead and get your guy.
Yeah, he should be there. And you're gonna run toward trees.
Alright, I got the right buff this time.
Watch for knights, they're coming from two sides of the three. And what's your buff, Astra?
It is Antumbra.
Ant? Yeah. You dunk on rock, then. Where's the knight? Oh, there's the knight! Awesome. Last one.
He's been invincible.
Of course, yeah. Run towards stairs as well. And dunk there. Awesome. Read again. Read again.
Read again. Not me.
It's fish, fish and seaweed again. Yeah. Where do you see that, Astro?
It's on my left side.
Yeah. What's your middle symbol, Astro?
It's a hawk flying downwards.
That's on my right.
Yeah. Tarp again. See, terrifying encounter when you put it in words, but you run into trees. Once you see it, it's not bad.
It's really not.
I didn't say them aloud, but you found where to dunk, so.
You get it?
How are you gonna run towards rock? Yeah, it's done. Yeah.
Cool, cool.
Before you kill it, make sure the car gets out of the room, Astra.
Gotcha.
It'll lock him in and he'll probably die otherwise, yeah. Alright, you can
I
go
got
kill it.
Tumbra, by the way.
That's a tree. Oh shit, the knight, my bad. Never mind.
I got him.
Not spawn from yet.
He's yeah, he took his sweet time. There you go. Okay.
So
you're gonna run towards stairs and you're dunking stairs.
Yep.
And that's the encounter once you do that. Watch knights from everywhere, but if he dunks quick enough we won't need to kill him.
Don't make him dunking stairs.
Awesome. Nice.
Oh, I got a red border fusion.
Kian's force red border. Yeah, me too. Nice.
Well, is controlled burst good?
That's the perk you want, yeah.
And I got envious assassin.
Oh.
And liquid coils and extended barrel and a charge time master.
That's pretty good. That's pretty fucking good.
And
pretty
it's
sure.
Arc.
Look. What is it? Can it roll reconstruction?
Can it?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure
yes,
like,
okay.
Almost all the
I thought it could, yeah.
Reconstruction now.
I like that every, yeah, pretty much every weapon we get is reconstruction. All right, so for the cheese for this, you're going to want Lament. Is there anyone that doesn't have Lament? I know, Guardian, you don't have Beyond Light, so that that's a no. Does anyone else not have it, though? Good. Do you have Tractor Cannon now, Guardian?
No.
Okay. Do you have Fallen Guillotine?
Yeah.
Okay, put that on.
This is a 1600 raid, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, you can run.
Don't worry about that.
I
recommend one or two copies of Loosened Blade on that chest.
Quick question: could someone come next to Carnome, who's a warlock, and pop a healing rift? I haven't tried Valiant Charge just yet.
Oh. Did they patch that?
Maybe.
Yeah, I think it needs to be a healing grenade. Yeah, it needs to be a healing grenade, I think.
Damn.
If it still works at all.
Yeah, they might have patched it. I never did get to try it, so. I hope they didn't patch it. I mean, honestly, that just feels like tech, you know?
Yeah.
We are we're doing the cheese, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm happy to explain it legit if you want to hear it, but... No. Yeah, you need to set aside, like, 4+ hours if you want to actually do it, so... I do recommend you do it at some point in the future, but... just for the experience. But... No rush, because it's tedious as fuck. For the cheat, well, first off, does everyone know how to use Lament optimally?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Two lights and a heavy if you really want to get the maximum. Do your full extent of lights for your first charge, but after that, just get away with the two.
Okay.
Alright, for the cheese, there's gonna be a door when we all get on these plates. It's gonna be by this this one here. Kenchi's, I guess, will take that plate. So when we all descend down, just make your way over towards Kenchi's. There's gonna be a doorway. You're gonna want to book it to there. Ignore the prompt to give Riven cookies. That is an old taunting event thing that they never removed from the game. That is an option, though. When we enter that room, we're gonna be looking for a shadow. If you want to see how that actually is going to work, if you look at this kind of black backdrop over here, there's a faint white glow kind of in the background of it. If you see a big shadow go in front of that white glow, then we stay on that side. If the ads spawn and 3 seconds pass and you don't see a shadow, we're going to turn around and head back a room, and we're all going to stand against the wall that is going to give us joining allies. Let that hit zero. Once you respawn, you'll respawn back where we came in the room. And you're going to run way over to this side right here by Lizard. Or just pretty much follow the group. We're going to drop down and quickly make our way to the other side to do damage. Much harder to do it from that side because lots of people get there slightly late. So we'll hope for the best and get the good side. When it comes time for damage, we're all just going to walk up to her hand together. I'll pop a well if someone else wouldn't mind doing that too so I can get the armor charge from it. Just start whacking away at that hand. One person per plate, so find your own. There's two more on the opposite side there. Ready? Or three more?
Then you're gonna go towards Kenji.
Again, Kenji's is gonna be by it. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh man, I was hoping to do something here. Well, it should be fine.
Sure.
Yeah, I'm all good.
Okay. Everyone on?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yep. There we go. Okay. You do get a cool cinematic shot of Riven as well. Start making your way over to Kenshi's. We do need to book it.
Almost fell in the hole.
Wow, okay.
Why were you going so slow, Carr? What the hell was that?
Yeah, I don't know, man. I kept getting booped by her. It was really annoying.
Oh, I know what you mean, yeah. Shadow. Nope.
No.
Run on back, everyone.
Right, teleport wall.
Yep. This is the annoying one.
So hug against this wall.
Just hug against it. Once you see joining, stop moving.
Bro, come on. Give me joining.
Once you get respawned at the top, just follow the group. Or run to the right. If we don't get it on this attempt, it makes sense because running over here always makes everyone pretty disheveled, so. Everyone come to the left side and get ready to do damage.
Yeah, it's gonna be pretty soon here. Be ready. Don't get booped.
I'm gonna do a bit of sunbrace. Hey, someone else is doing it too. Fuck yeah. Alright, come over by here, by me to the left. Begin whacking. Nice, we got it.
Perfect. First try.
I think that's the first time anyone's actually gotten it when I taught it on the opposite side. That never fucking happened. This part here, sorry. I didn't say it, but
you don't need to do this
if you don't want to. Yeah. We're heading upward so we can grab a taken strength, and that'll teleport all of us back to the final stand. After that, we do. Will probably be the wipe for damage.
Oh no.
Well, Astro appears to be doing that.
I just got boops.
Yeah, I know.
All good. We'll
Phalanxes are frustrating. I got booped in the right direction.
Saw that.
I got it now, don't worry. Whack her hand a bit more, snipe her mouth. I don't fucking care. Finish the health.
At this point, she should be pretty killable.
There you go. And now do the last thing you would ever expect to do, enter her mouth.
Yeah, don't get crushed by her mouth, though. Watch out.
She can do that, yeah.
It'll take a second for it to open. There we go.
You actually can't hit the mouth with Lament for some reason. Or the heart with Lament, I mean. There we go.
Cool.
And the only raid in the game that we do not end on a boss, so we are not done yet. I don't think I've ever heard Zavala talk for this part of the raid. In, like, her voice. That caught me off guard. Now, if you have the prompt to pick up the heart, do not. But you will be the one doing it first. You have a buff called Fate's Chosen.
So if you've got Egridge...
Who has Fate's... Who has it?
I do not.
Connor, do you have it?
Oh, it's me. It's me.
No.
Okay. So, how this encounter is going to go, we're now going to be running back all the way to that room I told you to remember before the vault encounter, with all the statues and shit. However, while we're running, there's going to be a bad debuff called, Creeping Darkness. if you are not close to the person holding the heart, that will build up very quickly, and at 10 stacks, you will die. Person with the heart is going to have a timer counting down. As that goes down, the aura around them that keeps you safe shrinks. When that countdown gets low, everyone's going to want to step outside of that aura so that you're not there when it hits zero. When it hits zero, the guy holding it gets sucked inside of the heart. Heart will choose a new person. Rest of us keep on going. Once the person gets sucked inside, they're going to see Taken Strength spawning. There's going to be one strength for every person that is inside the heart. And picking up the last strength that is on the map will extend the heart's timer. So whoever is running the second time will begin counting down. When it is low, the person inside the heart will pick up the strength, resetting the timer, giving them a bit more time to run. Next time it hits zero, though, there's no more extensions, so they'll get sucked in. So now there's two inside. Rest of us keep picking up the heart and continuing. Everyone, besides the first person, is going to pick up one taken strength the second they see them spawn. But the person who's first is going to keep waiting to pick that last one up. Because that only the last one's the one that extends. So if you aren't the one with Fate's Chosen now, you will not be
Waiting.
You'll just take it right away.
So when you get teleported, just listen to whatever I tell you to do. I'll only grab a taken strength if I tell you.
And everyone else, just stick with the heart, but don't be too close when it hits zero.
Yeah.
Like, step away at, like, two. You'll have enough time to survive. So
for this first one specifically, I'm going to go just past her tongue, and I'm going to drop down. If you want to eager-edge me to get me there sooner, then that helps. But everybody else, try to stop on the tongue. I will drop down, and then when I teleport, then he can drop down and get the heart. But just for the beginning, it's a little more annoying to mess up here at the beginning. So that's how we're going to do it. If you're going to use Eager Edge to fling me, only do it here and on longer stretches, because sometimes you'll just send me ricocheting left and right instead of straightforward. So
yeah, prefer to not flatten people.
Yeah, but once we're out of Riven's mouth, you can Eager Edge the guy with the heart. And as long as they're going the right direction, it's not too bad. So.
Yeah. They do hit the wall and there's adds, you will be one shot, so just be careful. Don't overdo it. My point.
Yeah, don't overdo it. But at least you don't die from the damage directly, so yeah.
All right, no, there's a chance.
I'm gonna
everyone pick come up here.
In 3, 2, 1.
Start going. I did it.
I egregged myself.
Hey, you actually got it. Danny's gonna stop on the tongue.
Yeah, everybody stop on the tongue.
He's gonna stop just past the tongue. We stop on the tongue.
Stopping right here.
All right, pick it up if that's you. It's you, Dupe.
Oh,
Dupe.
Shit.
Dupe. Okay. You're going to want to always be ready because we do not know who it's going to be. We lost one, though. That's perfectly fine. So.
Tell me, timer?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Okay, Guardian. Find one taken strength and grab it the moment you see it.
8.
Not yet.
7. 6.
Oh, yeah, not yet.
5.
Yeah, in a bit.
4. 3.
Step away.
2. 1.
Alright, so Guardian, you find one taken strength. Dupe, don't grab any. Oh, you could. Okay. Oh, Dupe, you're right next to one. Careful.
Oh my god, I didn't even see that.
It spawned right next 11, to you.
11, 10, 9, 8, 7.
Actually, Dupe, six, grab this one when it gets to like 3. 4. Over here.
3, pick it up. 2.
Pick it up.
Okay.
Nice. Perfect.
Ow.
Yeah, it spawned 3. I forgot it just does one seven, person that gets teleported.
6, 5, 4. 3, 2, step away. 1, 0.
All right. Everybody who's pick one. In here now, pick one up. Right now. I will grab the last one, which is over here. I'm going to
grab that one by you, Dupe. Grab that one. Yep. All right. Countdown. I think it's fucking, Kenshi's.
4, 3, 2.
Just take you. Okay. Kenshi's, don't go down the hole. Wait for it to reset one more time and pass it off to Astro.
So
if you go down the hole, it's a good chance that someone dies, so...
Yeah.
Dude, I just keep getting my Sunbracer shit. So
Astro, pick that up and drop down right away.
Okay.
Everyone take one.
I am going to get this one over by Carnum. I'm going to get the last one in case we need
and
it.
Just go ahead and take them. Just take them all now. Take them all.
Okay. Yeah,
he's pretty much there. Again, go to the side without the statues. Put it in the divot.
And we
there
got
you
it.
Go.
There's
Brad. Damn, I got another red border fusion.
And if you have Eager Edge, you can launch the ladies.
Nation of Beasts. Let's go.
If you right click with Eager Edge, you will launch the ladies.
I got someone boop me. And ever since Lightfall, for some reason, the heart's been off-centered. I don't know why.
All right, who's feeling lucky? Who's feeling lucky?
Whatever chest the lady lands on.
Which one is it? Which one is it?
It's this one.
My god, I got my
this
fifth.
This one, this one, this one? Okay.
Yeah, the one the lady landed on. It's gotta be lucky.
I got my fifth one.
I got 3 fusion red borders.
God damn. Go buy it from fucking Hawthorne now that you did the quest. You get the full craft already.
Oh my god. That's crazy.
Ew, she sounds like Aldrin. I hate that.
Dude, I've been getting insane luck. I got the fucking trace rifle first try yesterday, remember?
Got my fifth one, I think.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Lovely. But that is last wish. Yeah.
Yo.
Cool raid.
Our commentation's working for me. Damn, they're still not working for me.
Not me either.
No.
Last wish has been buggy with them.
That's
in particular. I know other raids have it happen sometimes, but every Last Wish recently has been this way.
You know, I think actually that Last Wish, they just removed it because people were farming it too much. That's my guess.
I did do that a little bit last season, but when the requirements were still going to be like 16,000 commendation score for ranks.
Who knows how to wellskate? I need to confirm something.
I do.
Okay, it's...
Ow.
It's... Eager Edge jump super like really fast. Okay.
Jump super close to each other. The heavy you want to delay a bit more after it.
Yeah. If you have enhanced Eager Edge, you can kind of hold your sword out for a second and then
I'd say learn it without the Eager. Like do it without Eager Edge being proxed to learn it. Just so you don't have to do that extra input. You just will go like this. You just go slow.
Wait, what?
Yeah. You don't need Eager. Eager just gives you the speed.
Oh shit!
So to learn it, do it without the Eager. So you just have like that extra input.
I used to be able to do it.
To relearn it, do it without it. It'll be better. Load into custom Rumble or not Rumble Mayhem match.
Yeah, there we go.
3 second supers.
That's actually what I did. I did it in that like white.
Okay,
it looks like
man.
It goes to eternity. Yeah.
Look at the even do it with Shatter.
This was fun.
So weird.
Oh yeah, no, I love that you can do that. Non-Eager Edge swords as well, you can do it with, even. It'll just be the funny slow.
Oh, that's so funny. Look at that. Look at how goofy it looks.
If you have no sword ammo, it's even better. You go so very slow.
It's just this burst. Okay,
let me run out of sword ammo.
Connor, what did you get? This raid.
Thanks for the raid, Slimy.
Hey, GG's, man.
But...
Don't need them. But thank you.
All right,
feel free to let me know if you need teaching elsewhere.
All right, word. Yeah, I still need to garden. feel like doing that one day.
I hate that raid, but I'll do it.
Yeah, that raid fucking sucks.
I'll let you know.
See you, man.
Alright, later.
There we go, finally no ammo, fuck. No, I mean, I fucked up the skin!
No.
Because the timing's different with no ammo, because you don't get any speed.
Connor, what'd you get?
I don't even know, let me see.
Yeah, this is actually kind of... There's some weird tech here for the Shatter Dive one. There's no use for this.
No.
Like, if you... Like, check this out. Let's see if I can do it again. Yeah, so if I now double jump, it'll still Shatter Dive wherever I land. Like, it doesn't affect...
I believe normal skating does that too, does it not?
Yeah, it probably does. I just... You're usually going so fast you don't even
know. I don't know if that's the... I know, yeah. I don't know if that's the actual effect. Like, I don't know if it's actually doing Shatter Dive, or it's just doing the visual.
That's so weird.
Oh, yeah, it's on a short cooldown, so...
Well,
if you're in the air for long enough, you can do a second.
I mean, it doesn't use your ammo if you do it right, you know?
Yeah.
So, it's possible. That's true. And it also doesn't use your well or your Shatter Dive, technically. I think it
That's true, yeah, because you can shatter right after you do the skate.
I think it's like they're canceling each other out to keep the momentum.
Yeah.
It's weird.
Yeah, I don't get it, but it works.
Connor, are you getting
like, look, now I'm doing a second Shatter Dive.
No.
It doesn't make any sense.
Are you?
No. Can I...
How people chain that shit together?
Can I ask you guys a question which is better? So, for the fusion rifle, I have Reconstruction and Kickstart, and Envious Assassin and Controlled Burst.
Both oh, the Envious coils. Controlled.
Okay.
Definitely, yeah. Okay. It's an ammo, or a reload saving perk, with the best damage perk, so.
But what about, I feel like, is Kickstart not good?
Well, what are you gonna use it for?
Well,
PvP. Is
if you're doing it for PvP, then you'd use Kickstart, yeah, but PvE, forget Kickstart.
Okay.
I'm heading to the tower to do
that. Doesn't Kickstart also lower damage? Or is that something else I'm thinking of?
It increases damage after a spell.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Oh. Never mind. Yeah, it's shorter.
I know what you're thinking of. There's some perks, like Quick Draw, that like lower
like
something massively, but...
They always do that with the fusion damage perks. It's so weird. They'll make it do a faster charge for lower damage.
I don't like that, yeah.
And it's like, okay, well, that's cool and all, but, like, you know, I'm not going to use
it. It feels not worth it in some cases, yeah. But, like, Riptide, you want that big time. Because you're not using Riptide for damage. You're using it to freeze, so the faster you can freeze, the better.
Yeah.
But that's kind of the one scenario.
Well, wait...
Yeah, PvP, the charge PvP time is important, different, yeah. I don't
do PvP. I feel like you always want the full damage in PvP. You wouldn't want to sacrifice it.
It's a high impact, maybe not.
Oh.
But others, yeah.
Huge error code moment.
Lovely.
Well, bye, I guess.
Fair enough.
Yeah, GG, boys. I'll see you around.
Yeah, see you around, man.
Drop that phone. Do you fall for dream about me? Drop that phone, creep on the floor, dream about me. Drop that phone, by the... Dream about me, park the car, drop that phone. Dude, can I, like, go to the tower? At all, please. I am pretty happy right now because my internet connection is finally better. We're with the different ISP. We were on Spectrum before and now we're on AT&T. I think my internet's freaking out, which is worrying me right now. Okay. Yeah, this is kind of dumb. Yeah, gun, got your makeup on, and you can't come. But yeah, it's nice because, like, before I would get, like, you know, download speed of like 300 megabits a second, which is not bad at all, like 300 something. And then an upload speed of like, at max, like 13 megabits per second. It's like, okay, well, there's kind of a weird disparity there. What's going on? And, I think we're finally loading in. Not sure what that was. And now with at the new apartment, we got new internet, and it's better because I just did a speed test to verify that things were okay, and I'm sitting at 370 download and 370 upload. It's like, okay, so this is how it's supposed to be, and Spectrum was just scamming us, basically. And AT&T is still scamming us, because all ISPs are pretty terrible and evil, but AT&T is scamming us less. We're paying a pretty similar price for much better connection. That's nice. I'm happy about that.
Hey there.
Was all my love wasted on you? The hell? And I would ask them, was all my love wasted on you? That was weird. I grabbed the sniper and then it just gave me the red border. I didn't even tell it to give me the red border. It just gave it to me. It's very weird. Was all my love. We'll just save it. I'm like, eh, maybe I could buy it and save it for the deep sight harmonizer or whatever. I was just like, why? Tomorrow's reset. I'll just do it when reset happens. Sometime later this week. We see it on you. Damn, I wish there was a fast way to complete Xenology that was like actually reliable. Well, I said it would be a short stream, and it still went later than I was expecting. Well, not expecting. I kind of knew this was going to happen. It always goes like that, and I was kind of hoping it would anyway. Let's go talk to Xur, even if we can't get the Xenology from him. Let's go see what he's got for sale, because I haven't done that this weekend, I don't think. Maybe I did, actually. Let's find out. We face a strange road ahead. In Watcher's Grave. Oh, that's that quest line. Not gonna do that right now. All right, hold on. What do you think about this? Okay. Lots of people come into Caesar. Even if I didn't take my Sparrow, it's kind of tradition to bring your Sparrow over and leave it. People don't really notice, but it's kind of an unspoken tradition, you know?
For all your, my will is not my own, is yours.
Kyra's armor, that's fun. It's good armor. 4 times for Dead Man's, Killing Wind for Hawk Moon, both okay perks, not my favorites personally. Graviton Lance being sold. If you don't have one, pick it up. It's currently pretty meta in PvP. High stat roll for Alpha Loopy with a kind of bad distribution and a decent stat roll total with very boring spread on Ahamkara for Warlock. The Hunter one is like, I don't know, if you don't have Orpheus Rig, pick it up, but it's not a roll to write home about. Yeah, those Ahamkara gauntlets, as boring as they are actually better than my current ones. Just barely. So we'll grab those. Alpha Loopy. My current is a 70 stat roll at its base. One of my only 70 stat rolls, so definitely not grabbing that. And I assume my Orpheus Rig is, yeah, it's at 67, so don't need those lame 63s. Let me grab this. Iris Handshake, goddamn. Let's use up some of these Sunnet Shards. Because I'm about to farm GMs this week, so I will be running out of those. Yeah, bring that over to... Let's just throw in a random stat so we can see the comparison. Yeah, 87. Yeah, the other one had a huge spike in mobility, and this one's a bit more evened out. Had high mobility and low resilience, and this one's just medium everything, and that's honestly preferable, so. Throw that onto my Warlock, bring the old one onto my Hunter and Dismantle. Those new Liar's Handshakes are 65 stat roll with terrible distribution. Okay, good. My current is 67, which with a much better distribution. I feel better about that. Cold Denial is an okay pulse rifle. This roll is Zen Moment Sympathetic, which is pretty meh. Definitely don't grab it. Tears of Contrition with kind of a bad roll, but if you need it crafted, turn it into a red border, go for it. Brass Attacks with a very boring surplus Wellspring, but hey, some people like those perks. Cartesian Coordinate with Under Pressure Swash. I mean, Under Pressure is not bad for fusion, especially if you're talking PvP. Swashbuckler's also fine. I mean, it's extra damage from a kill, so it's pretty self-explanatory whether it's good or bad in whatever situation you're thinking of. That's a nice stat roll on a chess piece. Not a good spread, but I'm from Gold Shield Disorient. I forget about that one a lot. Oh, yeah, that's interesting. But it's never really been too great. Rangefinder Demo on Threaded Needle. It's also, like, fine. I don't know. There are a lot of linears out there that are way better than Threaded Needle. And this particular role is not even that great. Zen Moment Demo on Gnawing Hunger. Gnawing Hunger is a great auto rifle. And this is not a bad roll. I mean, it's got Arrowhead. Ooh, it's got Full Bore. Jeez. Okay, you can get some good range out of this thing. Just missing a Range Masterwork to max it out, you know? It's got Accurized and Full Bore. It's kind of ridiculous for the range department. I am a fan of Gnawing Hunger. It's a great auto rifle. But this is not the god roll, but this is a good roll. I mean, Rampage is great. Really, the only thing it's missing is maybe a Range Masterwork, and I prefer Subsistence. That's me. Other people might say Zen Moment's perfect for their PvP needs or something. I don't know. So not a terrible roll, I guess, but not my preference. Hawk Moon, it's a fine roll. If you like Killing Wind, then you'll love it. Dead Man's Tale, it's less good, honestly. There are other better options. But, yeah, I don't know. It could be better. Okay. Well, that's that.
I think you have terrible need of my gifts. I do mean to explain, but every time I
one more rank. And I'll get my first deep sight harmonizer. You get 6 of them. Outside of this season, let's take a look at the weapons I need to craft still. Yeah, so the only things I need to craft are these tracked things that I have here, and then all of the new taken weapons, which I imagine I won't have too much trouble getting red borders of, because seasonal stuff's never too much trouble to do. As long as you play pretty consistently throughout the season, you'll probably get it like halfway through. I could probably be doing more seasonal content right now, but yeah. Yeah, I need to work on that catalyst. I guess we can track that.
I have explained it the best that I can.
It's annoying that that's not going. Centrifuge.
Be alarmed. I know no reason to cause you harm.
Malfeasance and Centrifuge both just need a bunch more kills to complete. So that's nice. We're getting there. Well, that'll have to be it for me. Only about 2 hours, which is actually a decent amount. I announced it was going to be a shorter stream, given the circumstances. So, sorry about that, but it is what it is. Can't really do much about it. I will definitely be on tomorrow. I really want to be, and I should be able to stream even with the work and unpacking and stuff, you know. Let's see. Oh, you know, hold on. Just looking at this. So I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, 11. Right? Let's check that. 3 plus 4, 7, plus 2 more is 9, 10, 11. Okay. Yeah, so I need 11 more patterns. 1 red border from Dares, 1 red border from Last Wish. I think I can get both those next week. So really, I just need 9? I could use Deep Side Harmonizers on all of these except for... or on all of these and then just get between these three, get 3 more red borders and be good. Or... even better, get a whole bunch of red borders for these, and then use harmonizers just to top them off, and then maybe still have a few harmonizers, and just use those to top off my ticking weapons. Whatever works, you know. We'll see how it goes. Anyway, now we'll do the ending. So, tomorrow, we'll do some, maybe some Gambit, maybe some JMs, maybe some Last Wish, just the once to get the Red Warner and be done forever. Maybe a few other things. You know, lots of stuff to do tomorrow, potentially. Slash the rest of this week here. Oh man, I was gonna do trials this weekend if I could. Not that I want to, but the new glaive's available. Man, that sucks. Okay. Ah, well, I think we'll be okay. Let me get a decent outro song going. Kind of would have liked this song to be the outro. This is Neon Skyline by Andy Schaaf. But we're not going to hear that as our outro song. We're going to hear something else. Well, we're on the Andy Schaaf kick. We got the Norm for the intro song off of the album Norm. The whole album is interesting. It's a story about a stalker. I guess that's all I'll say. I recommend it. Andy Schaaf and the album Norm. That's not what we're hearing right now. We're hearing Neon Skyline by Andy Schaaf. It's off his album, Neon Skylight, which is just about being a guy at a bar, like a regular at a bar. And it relates to a bunch of his other albums with some of the characters in there. Namely, Judy is a recurring character in a lot of his songs. It's great. I really recommend Andy Schaaf's stuff. There's a lot of really good storytelling and a bunch of recurring characters in certain things. It's nice, you know, it's nice. So we're hearing Neon Skyline right now, the song Neon Skyline, but we're going to hear Halloween Store by Andy Schaaf. That's going to be the outro. It's also off the album Norm, so it's going to have some stuff about the stalker in it. The album, despite its dark, meaning, it's very lighthearted in a lot of its portrayal. So it's an interesting piece, you know? It's good. I like it. So I hope you guys enjoy it. VOD watchers out there are probably sick of me talking about the music that's playing that they can't hear. Either way, this is, we just heard Neon Skyline by Andy Schaff, and now we're hearing Halloween Store by Andy Schaff. That'll be it for me. Thank you so much for watching. See you tomorrow.